Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm having an alcoholic beverage.
Oh, are you? It looks like
what I'm doing?
What?
I'm having an alcoholic beverage on the BB podcast.
Well, I'm glad that it's socially acceptable for you to have a beer on here and not for me to smoke a joint.
That's true.
You guys are dicks.
You're trash, though.
I am trash.
You're trash.
You weed smokers ruining society.
I got to drink me a ginger ale because my belly's all sore.
That's good. Sore belly.
I got a sore belly from I ate too many pistachios.
What do they call those pains that the men have when they're...
menstrual cramps.
Menstrual cramps. There you go.
What's today's date? I kind of started already.
September 20th, 2016.
Tuesday, September 20th,
2016. Hey, buddy. What's up, buddy?
Hey, buddy.
Man, we had a bad day today, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, my daddy came in here. He was fucking pissed off. His veins were sticking out. His hair was everywhere. He's screaming and yelling. I was like, what the fuck's going on here? I thought somebody fucked something up.
Is that what that big hole in the ground is from his massive penis and some thrashing it around or what?
So, like, he came in here and he was all pissed, and then I thought it was because of the cook. He fucking caught him smoking pot or something. Nope. His fucking, he had to buy a new mattress for his dick.
His penis mattress.
He said the other one, that's like the third one this year. He said they keep wearing out.
I'm curious about the placement of this mattress. Is it just like right next to the bed, or is it at the foot of the bed because it like hangs down? Is it another bed to put your penis on?
He lays on a cot, but he's got a king size mattress right next to the cot.
It's a nice cot.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that is a nice cot. This guy over here would love to have a cot like that.
Yeah.
Just to sleep on.
Yeah.
He could move between the two of them.
His wife has to sleep in the garage. There's no room for for my father, another human being, and his penis in the house.
Yeah. That's fantastic.
He's doing the old zimzam over there.
Zimzam. Zibwa.
He loves doing the zimzam.
Zimzab zibwa. I like how our setup time is just thrown right into the podcast, too.
Right?
That's pretty good. I like
it. Right to the fire.
You guys, you watch the news today?
I haven't.
You know who Pete Kontos is? He's a guy that owns Pete's Cafe and all those Greek fella. Mm-hmm. Well, anyway, there's a huge standoff. Apparently, Gary Kubiak... he took him hostage for a wheel of Euro meat, and he says if he doesn't get it by midnight, he's going to kill him.
A wheel of Euro meat.
I did hear that.
That spins around, and you shave it with a big old machete. Yeah. A wheel of Euro meat.
You give me a wheel of Euro meat, and Pete can live. I don't know if it's worth it, guys. You keep that Euro meat.
I don't think it is worth it.
I don't think it's worth it either.
That's a big goddamn wheel.
I mean, George W. really likes going to Pete's kitchen. So
that's
a pig, a lamb, and a sheep. That's three people. I wouldn't trade three people for Pete.
Wheel.
Yeah.
That's the best part about it.
Yeah, but
I'm holding this person hostage. I need a fucking. I need a spinning wheel of the Euro meat.
Yeah. I tell you what, we'll give you half a wheel, but no tzatziki sauce.
None of that tzatziki. I never liked that sauce. Do you guys sauce?
Me and Noemi made some vegan tzatziki sauce the other day. I never liked regular tzatziki because I always thought
it was the difference?
Greek semen.
What is it? How does it made? Yogurt?
Seeds. Yeah, they make it out of yogurt.
Yogurt, mint, and something, right?
Yogurt, mint, dill.
Cucumbers.
And garlic or something.
Cucumbers.
Like that.
I would do it out to cucumber.
No, I did it with a cucumber.
There's enough deal.
I made it with vegetable vegan sour cream, and I actually liked it.
Is that what it is? Sour cream?
Find any plain soy yogurt.
Oh. That's why it was good.
It was the vegan sour cream.
Because yogurt would be kind of boring. Yeah. I think that spiced it up a little bit.
We did some spicing.
Look at this guy. Look at that. He spiced it.
We got some dill and some mint.
One of the best dips I ever had in my life was I went over to fucking Matt and Jenny's house.
Yeah.
They're still married, and they took like a bowl of sour cream and they just put ranch seasoning in it and then just mixed it up.
Kay does that shit too.
Murder.
That's called the ghetto ranch dressing.
Oh, it's it was fucking fantastic. It's like eating a tub of sour cream.
That's buttermilk.
Who can argue against that? I can't.
I can. I never would eat sour cream until I was vegan either. I never liked sour
Vegan's
cream.
Vegan's best Good. Sour cream.
I never liked
awesome.
I never liked sour cream. I never liked ranch dressing. Anything that looked like cum, I wouldn't eat. But now I know it's not cum. That's why I won't need it at the goddamn Greek house. Because you just got this big fat guy wearing a wife beater and the hair sticking out and one eyebrow. And all this white shit on my gyro meat. And I knew it was cum.
Sure. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Don't eat it.
I'm put some lemon and some dill in my cum.
I like that garlic yogurt sauce, man.
Jesus Christ.
What's that?
I don't know. Whenever I get chicken at Mediterranean places, they give me this like really tart garlic yogurt sauce. Dude.
Garlic.
Nice. Quit going. You delicious. Go become a vegetable vegan.
No.
Vegetable vegan.
I don't want to.
Campus Lounge is supposed to become a vegetable vegan house.
Oh, good.
Yeah, the people that own
Saturday evening. Saturday evening and Sunday dusk. Be over there, be square.
At the Campus Lounge?
Yeah, absolutely.
I never went there. I went there one time before
one of the
Bronco
last,
game.
Last night, so going to be
you
open.
And,
was that Randy?
Aaron.
With
him
Aaron?
And Aaron.
Yeah.
And
it
then
wasn't
we,
Randy?
That was when we pissed behind the dumpster. And the cop was on the other side of the dumpster, and we were
nice.
All three of us pissing.
At the campus?
Yeah, well, no. We went to the campus, but then we went to
the Bronco game.
The game.
You think game. You talked about that on
we're,
here.
We're driving to the Bronco game like this.
Ribbiter, I don't even have no eyes. I can't see.
That's right. We were great. Anyways,
did
sorry.
You guys pee on each other a little bit?
We pee
you're saying Saturday, dusk to dawn?
Oh, the campus
actually,
is closing.
Patrick's got a better question.
Yeah,
did
me.
Did the three of y'all piss on one another a little bit?
Yes, we did.
I think we were close enough that, like, the mist, you know, like the
oh,
mist
yeah,
that
yeah,
comes
yeah,
off
yeah,
the piss.
Absolutely.
You might have smelled a
I
little mist.
I don't know
mist.
If it was with you, but I remember, like, the game letting out, and I couldn't get in the bathroom, so me and some
we're
other people.
In the trash
in
can,
in the trash
right?
can, yeah. yeah. And then, like, guys just came up, and we all formed a circle, and it's this big fucking
yep.
urine circle.
It's like, what are you going to do?
And nobody was bothered. It was like, yeah.
That right poor now. Mexican woman who had to clean it up.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she
that
used
been
it.
Horrible.
She had 13 gallons in.
That was probably...
It was just a cardboard box with a bag in it. So it wasn't
was
even like a real trash can.
The most sterile thing she had to clean up all that day.
That's probably
the,
true.
There's all sorts of horrible shit.
There's only
too.
One reason to go to live sporting events. To litter indoors and it's okay.
Yeah.
You're just throwing peanut shells
dude,
on the ground. No!
I have. That's all I do for
I
4 hours straight. And I just I throw life. Everything everywhere.
I know, Patrick. And Joseph just as much as I do.
I do. I love littering because I'm a very good boy outside of there.
Yeah.
Be careful of that sweet boy.
Me and my
no, this your headphones.
I go to that ball
that
game
Jack's
on
all
Sunday.
Fucked up.
Yeah, you watch out for that.
You went to the Jackson ball game.
They brought their
Jackson
trash.
Ball game.
Yeah, I brought my trash from home, dumped it all over the stadium.
Yeah,
but then me and my wife Noemi, who's my pregnant wife,
she's pregnant.
Right.
They go to do the old ding dong banner.
Yeah.
Yeah, we get down on our knee, put our fist in the air.
Oh, yeah?
Hell yes,
you
we
put
did.
Your fist in
did
the
you?
Air?
Like Tim Tebow?
No. Oh. Like, goddamn, the guys in the 68 Olympics.
Know,
you know what I'm saying. Only, about. But it wasn't that cool because we were outside.
No, that wasn't that cool.
Now when we
because you put your fist in the air like a superhero.
No,
smell your
we
fist.
Did it like a 1968 black nationalist.
Oh.
There you go.
I see. Yeah. I can get that more like
did you get any flack
Marvel.
For it?
People were looking at us because we were actually waiting in line trying to get in the stadium. We're like, God damn it, they're staying in the shit song, and I want to disrespect it in front of everybody. So we both just get on our knees, and we do that, and we're doing that, and people are looking at us, and then the planes fly over. I said, another symbol of American imperialism. Imperialism. And Andre's just shaking his head.
Oh, Andre.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Needed. I forgot Andre was there.
I don't know who that is.
And I told
he's
my wife,
yeah, you do.
He's the only person that
you
should
know.
Be a saint.
Yeah.
You know. I don't think he knows him.
Yeah, of course
he knows
yeah.
Andre.
You think he knows
he
Andre?
Know Andre?
Yeah,
Andre
3000. Yeah. He's seen him at least.
I doubt it. He doesn't come here at nights on the weekend. Why are you offended that he
you
doesn't
didn't
know
play
Andre?
Volleyball, did you?
I don't play volleyball.
Okay, sold.
Yep.
Sold. You do not know Andre. That's
I
how
do
he
not
decided.
Because
you've never done a volleyball in your life.
Woe is me. I'll never be able to make it.
I really think it would be quite humorous if you could come up with a complete sentence that states the word belated in a positive manner.
What's belated in a positive manner?
Well, I belatedly went through the red light and
very nice, very nice, very nice.
Semi truck.
Have him talk to the law enforcement. That's a good one.
Is that what happened to you earlier?
Oh no! When I called you and I told you I fucked up.
Yeah. Well, it's pretty funny. He's like, I fucked up real big time, and I'm like, I got a beer to pour. And I hung up.
No, I didn't have no beers to pour.
No, I did.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah, you're wicked busy.
Wait, what did you do now?
I don't think he was in a murder or something.
He fucked up big.
I can't even go into it. What do we got?
I definitely was involved in a murder. I fucked up big.
Yeah, what kind of murder?
Wow.
Did you put it in a trunk?
It's like a rapper confession in the studio.
Apparently I'm dyslexic.
Yep. Oh.
They thought, they told me to red rum them.
They told me to red rum them. No, a Norwegian blonde fucking wide-nosed gal told me to get her a leaf in the shape of a heart. But my dyslexic mind heard a heart in the shape of a leaf.
Ah.
And then he killed a
goat.
Yeah, goat. Remember? He did that last week.
So I didn't know what the fuck to do with the carcass after I got back when she turned me away.
Is that what that call was about?
Corcus?
You and me are a good team because you say the same joke every week and I forget it every week. It's like a new joke for me every week and then hear my
name. No, man. This is true, man.
That's because I watch it like three times trying to edit it.
All right. I messed up.
No, I don't edit it anymore.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah. I just put a thing on top.
Gummy corpse, that bloody corpse. Man, gummy all blood. All them supermarket bags, they all got like holes in them, you know? So I got blood all over the back of my truck. I got blood dripping up to the front of the food bank. And like, what the hell are you doing? I'm like, I got a bunch of meat for your donations. Like, get out of here. I'm calling the cops. So I messed up big time.
This time it's a little darker. Last time it was a little more humorous. This time he's taking a little more serious.
Okay, I see.
I killed your mother.
I liked it last time. You were killing it last time. This time,
I know.
He's doing so it. Look back he's drunk in the catalog. Yeah, what the hell was that guy drinking? It looked like he was drinking Sailor Jerry.
Drinking a Fody. Bop, bop, bop.
Drinking Fodies.
Hey, did you guys watch the news today?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Fucking
news? What did I miss? I was watching the news and the Donald Trump come out.
Yeah.
And he's a... he's convinced me, I guess. I'm going to make America great again and all that.
Yeah,
right. Anyway, so
he, great.
So he was like, he was talking about the civil rights and how we should give him credit for it. He was like, my family owned Martin Luther King's family. And we were excellent slave owners, excellent slave owners. There was nobody more terrific at owning slaves than we were. We were great to them. We were great to them. They had silver dog bowls we fed them out of. I'm not giving them gold. Gold's for the family. But, yeah. So that's it. So he's really catching the eye of the African Americans,
right? And then buying the taco bowl at Trump Tower.
He had a taco bowl.
Yeah, that
he owned Martin Luther King.
He owned Martin Luther King.
Yeah,
that's what happened in the news today.
Well, that reminds me, our dad. We used to eat out of gold bowls until the royalties quit coming in.
The gold bowls are only for the whites.
No, we had gold bowls. Our dad used to feed us out of.
Yeah.
Then his royalty checks from. Writing. You're writing that song, I Like the Cars That Go Boom. His dick wrote that. I like the cars
that go boom.
But then
boom.
All of a sudden he sold his royalties off and they quit and then we had to eat out of silver bowls. Doesn't that suck, Sabado?
Silver bowls.
Silver
you didn't
bowls.
Know my dad's dick made music. Did you?
It's Christmas time for my penis.
Yeah.
He did that one with Nat King Cole.
He did. That's a lot of people don't realize is that that song where that
unbelievable.
That was he did a duet with his penis and Nat King Cole where they superimposed.
So it was a trio.
And then the penis opened up. Unbelievable. It's Christmas time in the city. I don't remember that. Oh,
we got to have a My Dad's Dick segment.
My Dad's
absolutely.
Dick.
My Dad's Dick segment.
Yeah.
Segment.
Yeah, so it was a trio. It was Nat King Cole, my dad, and my dad's dick. And then that's when the Natalie Cole decided she wanted to sing.
Yeah, she was like,
my dad's dick perform.
I can sing better than a dick.
No, she was inspired by the dick.
Right.
My father's penis is very throaty.
Right. I imagine it would be.
It's a very gravelly sound.
When you have the gravitas of the penis like that big,
as the skies of green, a nice on Tatooine,
a nice
yellow bananas.
That's a Star Wars joke.
A baritone growl.
Right. I want to become a scientist and be on those shows just so I can stay Star Wars.
Star Wars.
Star Wars.
Sometimes we need to go up to the stars and have wars.
You may get the wars on the stars.
That's good.
No, I lamed that one out.
What about traffic and weather?
The following story is fictional. It does not depict any actual person. On that. Audio discretion is advised.
Yes, indeed.
So I can't believe you were going to try to pull that goat shit on me on the phone earlier. Is that what you were going to do?
I built it up for this moment.
Jesus the moment Christ. Before.
Yeah. The goat.
I knew the goat joke.
Hey, I spent a full $1 at the dollar store on that
what about tax?
Cookie cutter in the shape of a maple leaf. Shit, serious, man. That's a fucking buck.
That's a dollar.
Yeah.
I was sitting there the other day, you know, the young Frankenstein?
Frankenstein.
27?
Yeah, no, it was that Wilder Gene movie, and I'm just sitting there. I couldn't look fatter. I'm sitting on the couch, and I had a big smile on my face, and my buck tooth is sticking out, and you just, I think my fat's sticking out inside the pants. And I'm just breathing out of my mouth with a big smile on my face, going, and I'm just watching, and I'm loving every minute of it. I'm just going, and then I look over at Noemi, and she's just staring at me with pure hatred in her heart. She couldn't have been more displeased with how disgusting I am.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
That Wilder Gene.
I was going to say that. He's the wilder one.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like I was saying before, it takes a special woman to handle a dire feller. At least there's these two.
Yeah.
And they have to deal with some awful things.
Yeah, I heard that your father came in fucking raging mad, hair everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, he got rid of his mattress last night, and he came on in, and he's
he
like,
didn't
God
get
damn
rid
it.
Of it. He broke
God
the box spring.
I got nowhere to rest my dick. I sleep in a cot. Where was my penis going to go?
Yeah.
Yeah, he had to rest his... He didn't even rest his dick.
I like
that.
That story better. His dick's cot was broken. Or no, he's sleeping on the cot.
But he's got nowhere to
rest
his dick.
Rest of the bed.
His dick was on the box spring.
It was on the mattress, yes.
Box spring.
Yeah, you got to have a dick cot.
Who's the opposite of Christopher
Walken? Did you know they
make
bunk bed cots?
Christopher Reeves.
Did you know that? Because you know why I know that? Because that's where me and him are going to live when divorces go through.
I can't wait till
we're going to have a bunk bed cot upstairs in the liquor room.
I'm totally going to come see you too.
Did we do the joke that Christopher Reeves didn't stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
No, I like that though.
No one did it. White privilege.
I like that.
Fuck you, Christopher Reeves.
Yeah.
That son of a bitch fell off a horse.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did. What a fucking way to go, dude. That sucked.
And then his wife stood by his side and died of cancer.
Yeah.
She should have ditched his ass and sucked as many dicks as she could.
She was sucking dicks, dude.
Well, I hope so. Hopefully in front of him, too. He couldn't do anything.
He probably liked it. He was probably the inventor of the cuckold porno category.
He thought eating another man's jizz would make his spine grow
back. Is there rules to cuckolding?
Makes sense.
Do you have to clean up the other man's product?
No.
Because if that's the case.
No. I don't think you have to do anything besides just watch.
What the fuck is cuckold?
It's like when you let your girlfriend fuck other men and you watch
You watch it.
Oh, I'll tell you a quick story.
I want to hear
this
story.
You a quick story?
This is a true story.
This is an honest truth story.
Please.
So yeah, you know, I was hanging out with this one gal at one point. You know, I knew she had a boyfriend, and she knew that I knew that she had a boyfriend.
Did her boots have buckles on it? And
she
you had
did,
a boyfriend?
Yeah, but good old buckle boots.
I knew that she had a boyfriend, and she knew that I had a boyfriend.
She asked me, we're driving deep in the woods, wherever. She says, "Hey, Polly, would you be okay if I left my boyfriend and started dating you? And, you know, we'd have an open relationship." And I'm like, no. Well, I got out of the car. I pulled the car over.
Mm.
Lit up a cigarette. Got back over. Back in the car. I'm like, nah, sweet. You know, that's just not for me. You know, that's just for the birds. It's not for me. I can never fucking pass out 3:48 a.m. with my dick in my hand after jerking off, have you come in at 5:52 and, you know, take a sniff and be like, oh, it smells like you're over at Frank's place. How's his great grandmother's colitis treating her? Is it getting better? So cuckold is...
You just do it all in the room together.
Yeah, you like to watch your girlfriend or wife get fucked.
Mm-hmm. I do too.
Okay.
I tell you, me and Malkova, I've seen her get fucked a few times. Yeah. That's going to be my future wife.
You like
Who's
that?
Who's Malkova?
Malkova.
Me One of them porn stresses?
Yeah. I've seen her get fucked once or a few times.
Yeah, like in the same room?
I guess I'm a good old cuckolder because I'm telling you. Okay. It used to be Pamela
Were you in
Anderson
the room now?
They invented There's these videos.
Nothing wrong with it. You know what I mean?
It's a goddamn joke, my friend. I'm killing it.
No.
I think it marks a cuckold.
No, I'm
never cuckolded any of Sabado's
I'm
girls
not a
for him.
Holder, I'm a cuckoldee. Like,
oh, you would know? Do the fucking.
Yeah, I do the fucking.
I had a customer ask me to do
watch
that
me
once.
Fuck a girl.
Yeah. That's what
I was
I mean.
Like, probably 2021.
That's his fault.
And I said, no, I should have done it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Where the fuck
what happened?
You?
Oh, okay. Let's start from the
Let's start from the beginning. He's like.
They was my customers.
Yeah.
And they asked if I would come
to be a third wheel.
Well, no, he wanted me to fuck her in front of him.
Right.
Yeah.
That's good.
Really?
Okay.
Yeah. Really.
Yeah. When you're 20 something.
And I wasn't even going out with anybody. I should have done it.
Yeah. What was your problem?
I don't know. I was nervous.
You just get freaky.
Yeah.
Just
yeah. It stick. All sounds good 20 years later. We're
right.
In the moment.
I know.
Yeah. Why didn't I? She had
was
half
she hot
a leg.
Or what?
She was decent.
Well, then
she had half a leg.
She wasn't gross or anything.
Yeah.
500.
I guess I was afraid I would just come too quick and ruin everything. Oh, my cummies came out. And then
you're young. You could go again.
Yeah, that's probably true.
You know what I mean?
My cummies came out.
We were severe drunks when we were like 21, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're
yeah.
Dick didn't
work then. Yeah,
you
dick.
I had a harder time coming when I was 20 than I do now.
Oh, yeah.
It's because I drank whiskey for breakfast.
Yeah. That was good.
He's thinking about it. And you're so I did, too.
He's been drunk since he was 2.
I think last week he was lesser drunk.
Yeah, he was in the parking lot.
Yeah, how'd you end up with that vagrant again?
I ended up all night. Oh, man.
What the fuck was that? How did he end up back here again? We should have never
Ryan
seen him again.
Stand yet?
Yes, let's go.
All right.
We should have never seen him again.
I pledge allegiance to the America of the other states that you forget about.
Hey, didn't you say he wanted to fuck you or something? You fucked the man.
No, we were talking. Y'all boys told me, bet you that man wants to fuck you.
Like,
yeah, he wants
really?
To fuck you.
And, you know, he's banging
remember?
On the fucking windows. Just be like, let me in, Paulie. And I'm like,
no,
I think
and I went
you guys
pissed.
Are right. I think he wants to fuck me.
Yeah.
And then he was out there. He's like, are we going to be friends or what?
Right.
Yeah. Remember that? Yeah, I remember that.
I do.
Yeah.
I thought we were going to be friends. Oh, fuck you.
So you guys are good friends now.
Well, you know, if I see him crossing a railroad track, I'm not going to be like, get away from my tiles.
I believe you both hung out at a railroad track.
How many times have you seen him since the last time that he was
This is here? It, probably.
One or two.
Okay, I was just wondering if you guys...
Where at the Campus?
Dude, there's a lot fucking other intelligent shit I could be talking about.
Dude, ask well, we've been
questions.
Waiting.
Like,
did you ever catch up to the chick that robbed you? Did you ever figure that out?
Yeah.
She got back with you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You talked to her?
She emailed you?
I didn't talk to her.
No?
No.
I fucking used
I
a maple leaf cookie cucker.
I stared at her from outside.
No,
her.
I fucked up, man.
I
she
stared at her.
She did not steal my wallet. I dropped it underneath Pat's passenger
oh,
seat.
Oh, good.
Yeah, remember?
Oh, okay.
You want to hear my social security number?
I did write that letter, though, to her. I'm like, hey, miss.
You fucking creep.
Well, I was about to say, she wrote, she said where she worked
to and
on
from
air.
Trader Joe's.
Oh, yeah, she did, didn't she? Something on 6.
Yeah, she said where she worked on air. So like,
that's true.
Like, if she really did
and
rob
my brother
oh, yeah.
told me her pho was crap.
Oh, yeah. Yep. No, the vegan pho was
oh,
terrible.
Oh, yeah,
she's
it's horrible. She works on pho on 6th?
Pho on 6th.
Yeah, something
I don't
like
think
that.
Anymore.
Probably
not. Oh,
what
you're
are
just
you
saying
seeing?
That.
The turnover rate in pho places is
I might have chased her away
that's true.
Looking for my wallet.
Yeah, that place is horrible.
Where's my wallet, Mrs.?
Where's your wallet?
There's a lot more bad pho than good pho in Denver.
Daddy
pho?
The
best place you got to go is Fanatic on Colfax and Grand. Excellent vegan pho. That pho in six, all it was dirt, water, and basil leaves.
What time is it open till?
Dirt water time.
I don't know.
Dirt five, water. Four, three, six.
Do they make eight. Good regular ass pho at the place you're talking about?
How the fuck should I know? I wouldn't eat no regular ass pho.
Do they do a regular ass? Yeah. Okay, well then good. That's all I'm talking about then.
That was insane.
If their vegan one's good, then the regular one's good.
You will eat the vegan one.
I will not.
Lost his mind.
Vegan one's better. I want crushed up fish oils in my fucking soup.
I don't like no fish oils.
That would suck.
Mm.
So that's why I feel bad like about having a child is because of Mark.
Yeah?
Yeah,
eating
Mark.
Fish.
Yep.
You fish piece of shit.
That's right. Whoa, that's mine, man. You, I'm three. You're four, I think.
So me and my brother are starting a new band.
We are. Did you hear about this band?
Oh.
It's called Arcade Dyer.
Arcade Dyer.
I still don't get it.
Arcade Fire is a gay band that everyone likes.
I don't know any of their songs.
Well, I shouldn't say gay because that actually insults gay people, I think. But
you bad boy.
Speaking of that, in my notes, I was going through my notes, and sometimes I'm just sitting around and I'll be a little intoxicated and I'll write something down and be like, I don't have the strength to write out the whole bit, so just write down a couple of words and remember it. And then I wrote down hometown homo, and I had a whole bit. And I don't know.
And you don't remember it?
I have no idea what it was.
That's how I got the dick mattress bit.
Yeah.
I woke up this morning. I was laying there. Then I came up with the dick mattress.
The dick mattress. Badoo-doo.
You know,
I forgot about it. Almost forgot about it, and then I heard dick on the radio.
Oh.
And it reminded me.
Oh.
Richard Sanders.
That Trevor Simeon is too quiet. I think there's something wrong with him.
Yeah.
The Lord.
We're going to find out that he's a freak.
He's a mongoose.
He's probably a lordman.
He likes to asphyxiate himself when he masturbates.
Got to absolutely. With a name like that. With the name like
Is he
Trevor.
Got a BlackBerry over there?
Simeon.
Or is that a remote control?
Yeah, it's a BlackBerry.
Wow.
He's been digging up. He went down La Platte.
Must have found it.
Found an old phone.
Fantastic. They can't track you on that thing.
Ain't no shit.
Oh, that's good stuff, dude. That's good. You're the greatest.
Simeon, is that how you say his name?
Simeon.
I think his name was Seaman, but he got teased too much.
Simeon.
And that's how he learned how to throw the football.
The football.
Colbert?
Colbert Samsonite.
Colbert?
Colbert.
Colbert?
Colbert.
What's he asking me?
Tomato, tomato. Simeon Simon.
Yesterday, tomorrow.
Simeon. Seaman. His name was Mr. Seaman Face.
So what'd you guys do the lips donkey? You really pissed him off.
Yeah, my brother pissed him off. He called him up and he said, WW Diner.
Nice. Yeah. WW Diner.
A 176er.
That's when I was saying Niner all the time, and I was like, Niner just doesn't sound good in this song.
Sixer.
Well, six is pretty good.
Yeah, we were probably drinking a six-pack.
I was probably making fun of 1056. If we're going to be honest. That I don't remember, but I think that makes more sense.
How did they come up with that name anyhow?
176er.
1056. Oh,
they said they looked at the clock.
They looked at the
something.
Clock when they were like...
Losers.
They were tired of making band names, and it was 10 o'clock or 10:56, and
that's a good way to do it. We should.
You think
that.
They came up with it at 10:54 and like, yo, blokes, what the fuck do you think?
You think the four sounds?
Yeah,
like,
yeah. Hey, yeah.
Let's wait 2 minutes.
Do you think
minutes.
We just look at the time
in like 2 minutes?
Let's agree at six.
Yeah,
that's
so
true.
It took them a minute and a half.
Is that
like,
the
God,
truth, you sons of bitches?
Yeah,
I'm looking at you up there. Mark's been burping a lot tonight. Where'd you eat?
I went to Chipotle.
Whoa, did you get a big burrito?
A bowl.
No. Why? What's wrong with the tortilla?
No, I usually eat the tortilla. Just
I love
today.
Tortillas.
He smokes a tortilla and eats the insides.
Right.
Yeah.
I got me stocks and tortillas.
I've been watching a lot of pregnant porn just to learn how to please my pregnant wife.
There you go.
That's and, good.
But I don't. I mean, it kind of disturbs me because I'm watching this girl and she's just going, oh, the baby is coming. The baby is coming.
I haven't seen anything like that, but that's pretty hot.
That never happened. But I don't want that to ever happen when I'm having
Look at him. That ruined him.
I got Paul from across the room. Hell yeah.
So you got him good.
Are you kidding me? Back at you.
Back at me.
Wow, back man. Me. Yeah, pregnant porn. That's a good stuff. That's good stuff.
I've never watched it before.
Oh, it's good.
It's not because I wouldn't. No, I'd watch anything. I just haven't. I haven't gotten there yet.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's good stuff.
I guess you guys have matured more pornography than I have.
Right. Well, you get
desensitized.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
But you guys are up to the pregnant women. I'm working up to that.
To the degenerate porn. Yeah.
There's no. I haven't spent a moment by myself 6-7 years now.
Six to seven.
I haven't even seen pornography.
6 to 7 years now.
The closest thing I come to pornography is like when they have a dentist commercials and they show a lady with white teeth. Look at my white teeth. God
damn it.
I'm like, oh, fuck, I ain't seen teeth like that.
You're a white teeth kind of guy. Time. Yeah.
No, I don't.
He's like just white. A dentist kind of guy. Dentist porn.
American
I went to the
Dental
dentist yesterday or something on Monday. What the hell is today?
Yeah.
And they got some girl there.
The same one that we go to?
Yeah, that Sandy's guy. Then so it's with a new girl. And this was, I mean, she wanted to talk and stuff like that, but she didn't had nothing. She was like, I'm from Iowa. And I'm like, oh, that's good. It was like, we've got cornfields there, but here we got the mountains. I like the mountains.
And is she younger?
Yeah. I mean, she was probably in her early 20s. We didn't talk too much.
They usually have the worst timing at dentist's office.
About?
Like the talking. Well, it's probably on purpose. Yeah. They're like, you got your mom's a meatloaf recipe.
Yeah, and they're like drilling out the middle of your tooth or something.
So why don't you tell me about your dad's cock?
But they don't really want to know. That's why they ask.
They don't want to know.
Oh, that's good.
Because they already know.
I was because they say dentists are. That's the high. Nobody kills themselves more than dentists, except for maybe like veterans or something. Because we can understand that. But I guess I'd kill myself if I fucked around with teeth all day. They're but the disgusting. Dentist always comes over at the end and he's just smiling. And his teeth look like they've been. Like he polishes his teeth every day.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, ooh.
That's a damn well better, right?
Yeah, I guess.
What's wrong with your hat where you won't even touch it?
But I want to know why he wants to kill himself.
Yeah,
Look, it was like, why do you want to kill himself? And I also want to ask him.
I think about that a lot when I'm there. Or when I hear that statistic, I think of him specifically.
Yeah, why you want to kill yourself. And I also want to ask him if he recommends Dentine. It's like 100 out of 102 dentists recommend Dentine. I'm like, why would you ever recommend gum?
You're the one.
Nobody recommends gum.
$500,000 check.
Do they call him?
Yeah,
do they call up every dentist.
We got this nice package.
I'm calling.
Did you know my dad's dick used to have a public broadcast show?
It was gonna turn into a cable access show, but then podcasting popped.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah,
so. Podcasting pop. Not as pops his penis, but podcasting pop. Yeah, right.
Just really killed the Wayne's World type dream that everyone had. You know
me and these.
His dick's voice was too deep for the radio.
Right.
It just didn't translate.
I tell you what.
Really
if if they had them, I tell you two things real quick.
It's an A.
Option A.
One.
The day they come out with the affordable sex robot is going to be the day my dick don't get hard. And I'm going to be like, isn't this ironic?
I'm an ironic.
Hey,
uh-huh.
I need a Paul translator again.
I thought we were going with option B.
When they make
option B.
Okay, option B. Go for option B.
You don't have to explain it to him.
Yes, he does.
Yeah,
I don't know what the fuck option B was yet.
Yeah, no, I need the whole thing. Go ahead.
Option one was when he gets when the sex robots come, he's afraid that his dick won't get hard no more.
Okay.
It's going to be
afraid,
like.
Afraid. I almost goddamn guarantee that'll be the first day.
They'll give you some sort of like a nerve punch and your dick will go, jibbingy.
Yeah, it'll be. They know what to do.
Yeah, they'll figure out.
You're going to be okay.
I'm going to drink their fucking juice.
I want to drink the oil out of your butt.
You guys watch pregnant bitches. I eat the juice out of
Send me a pregnant robot. I want a pregnant robot.
Oh, man.
Shoots oil on my
face.
That
was some hardcore, deep, dark down shit you saw.
Let me drink it.
You imagine having an intercourse with a pregnant lady, and she'd be like, careful, you're going to make the baby come.
See, he got a replay, and I got a replay.
His head's so sensitive.
That's how you know it's landed. If you get the replay.
Oh, yeah.
How was your convention?
No, it's not till next month.
It's not till next end of the month.
Oh, yeah, my dad's PBS show. It was my dad's penis.
His PBS show. Yeah,
yeah. His was dick. Him?
I remember the most pointed conversation. He had the Monsignor from the local the church house.
The Monsignor house.
The Monsignor comes down and he's sitting there, and my dad's penis is just flapping his urethra, and it's just like, hey, you know, on the subject of the resurrection. why would God break the rules of the universe he created to impress a bunch of monkeys with chimneys?
On the subject of re-erection.
Yeah, on re-erection.
That sucked for Dad. He used to have to stand off to the side. His dick's getting all the limelight.
Yeah.
Signing autographs.
And when my father dies, I think he'll be lying there. I think the penis is going to go first. He's just going to be looking all sick. And then then the penis pulls out of his pants and it's got wings. And it detaches and just flies up to the heavens.
Why?
Because his penis is an angel.
It's heavenly.
It's a heavenly creature.
It's gonna be ask him himself.
It's gonna be singing like Louis.
His skies are green. Tatooine.
Yellow bananas. Do dapty do.
Dabo dabo do.
Nice. I gotta piss. Jesus Christ. Bring me another liquid, boy. Don't really. I wouldn't drink it.
I would give it to you.
Yeah, you don't want him pouring nothing like that, man.
I love
it. I'll tell you what, my friends. Honest to goodness, kind of sounds like disgusting porno that you'd be talking about. Like,
yeah,
you look
dirty stuff.
Yeah.
You know the dirty stuff, don't you? Oh, God in heaven.
If I was a dentist, I would recommend chewing tobacco.
That's what the
USAA
says.
Tells you.
That's what the chat says. And I think these guys are fucking scientists in the fucking chat. We have a chat here.
You have a chat room?
A chat room for
There's a chat room ASL. For the podcast.
Yeah.
In fact, I just looked at it. My dad was like, I hope you're enjoying yourselves. I'm sorry, Dad.
That's a good, honest, fucking truthful fact. That was a beautiful.
You know, that story reminded me. I saw this Facebook post that, like, this guy died on a motorcycle, and they said they, like, took a picture and they could see, like, his spirit leaving. Have you seen that shit?
That's what it reminded me of, like,
the penis dying, and, like, someone takes a picture and they're like, oh, you can see the penis leaving the body.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, he had
that's good shit.
He had a long, hard life.
Yeah. Hard-hearted life.
A hard-hearted life. What was I answer?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm going through my stuff. Let me see. This is my last note of the night. And it's not even that interesting. This is no hell yeah. I'm like really done with everything.
All right.
It was like I find watching a rabbit eating an envelope more exciting than watching a lion eat a gazelle.
Yeah.
I do that all day. That's my day now.
Really? Like, they eat envelopes?
Oh, they eat whatever you throw in front of them. I didn't write it.
Whatever you
I watch it every day. And it is exciting. I love to see
Absolutely. Where would you start if you're a rabbit eating an envelope? If you're a Benicula and you're trying to put red in a fucking folder? Oh, Marco.
I bet you the rabbits get stoned off the fucking gum.
Sound like you're a rabbit.
On the,
God forbid envelope. You got to eat a fucking a calendar, a folder. Envelope.
I'm okay with eating paper.
I would be down with watching the rabbit eat the envelope.
High in fiber. That's why he's doing it.
Sounds very entertaining.
No, I like watching it.
He's trying to get nice and fibrous so you don't stick the thermometer up his ass anymore.
That could be the case, but I think that's a problem. Is because like I'm gonna eat a pillow now, and I just like I show up and he's eating a pillow and there's just like stuffing everywhere and his stomach's all bloated and it's just stuffing and I'm pulling it out of his mouth. He's like, I can't shit, Daddy, I can't shit. And then I take him, I take him to the doctor. And the doctor
then you
says,
don't have to stuff him after he dies.
Yeah, I know. He's going to die young. I've got, and then I'm going to be stuck with the rabbit that hates me.
Oh.
Yeah. The black one.
Yeah.
That's what I always thought about that. Perry.
Yeah.
He's still living.
Yeah.
Goddamn 13, 14 years old now.
Dog? Cat?
Cat.
Yep.
Cat dog.
Pair of cats.
Cat dog.
They're all going to die at the same time. It's going to be nice in one way.
Yeah, because they can get a bunch of new cats.
No.
Yeah, you love cats.
No. I married into those cats.
You're a cat lady.
Yeah, you do. I had two cats.
You knew exactly what you were taking. No, you loved it.
Oh.
You were as committed to that.
So, if anyone wants to send us an email ever, you can send it to brothersbrew.
Somebody send us a fucking email.
Brothersbrew@gmail.com since our entertainment left us. They don't fucking
Yeah, those
anymore.
Were some of the best things that ever happened to us.
Yeah, I never had anyone make raps about me.
Nope.
It's really great.
And there was a whole string of them. I guess you know, what we could do is...
Hey,
there we go.
What?
That's what we could do as our music project.
What?
We could just write the album using those lyrics.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Actually, it is.
That's why we
that
know
is a
that
great
we're
idea.
Not violating.
So you and I will make an album.
We're making an album.
So
well, I got to figure out how to make good
what are we going to call it?
Beats. Lips Donkey is a prick.
Lips Donkey is a dick.
Wait, yeah, Lips Donkey. I sure as hell ain't going by Donkey Lips.
This shit is
Yeah, Donkey Lips is dumb. Lips Donkey is the best.
What's Blackberry doing over there?
Great.
Oh, is this his song?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You could turn down this whole copyright.
Play
bullshit.
The whole shit on then.
Yo, I will, but yo.
I can't hear you.
Kill the classical.
I can't hear you. Is this you? Oh, good job. Get it a little closer. This is a call original.
Yo, Chrissy, I was just adding, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's because you got your shitty fucking BlackBerry. I gotta turn it up. Oh, God. Now I have to turn it way down. You're... It's all right, so one. Yeah.
It sounded good.
Yeah, it sounded great.
So what did you do
That's
that
a beautiful
on
song.
Tin? He's having a moment over there. Look at him. I wish I could have that much of a moment when I was playing.
I know, really. I know. I wish I was really into what I played.
Yeah, especially three chords or whatever you just did.
Yeah, that's great three chords,
How'd
too.
You get in there? He's wrapped in it.
I don't know what he does. I don't know how
That's
he does
impressive.
This. Yeah, it is.
I thought I That's was clumsy.
He just bared his soul with us, and you made fun of him, Patrick.
Yeah.
What are you doing here?
I've never been able to not do that. It's
you gotta
terrible.
You got to accept.
No.
You got to accept people's level of artistry.
If there wasn't real big jerks like me,
I think
then no
great.
One would get better at anything.
Then there'd just be a bunch of Dave Mustaines making music. A bunch of dickheads trying to
that.
Fucking...
He hasn't made a good album in a long time, and I loved his music.
Yeah, like almost 30 years now.
I'd say Euthanasia was his last good album.
Yeah, what year was that? 94?
Rust in
Was
peace.
It that long ago?
It was a long fucking time ago.
Rust in Peace.
That was the 80s, wasn't it?
Rust in Peace was 89 or 90.
What's the tornado?
It's crazy the progression to their band.
That's on Rust in Peace.
Oh, did you hear that Souls. Victor Wooten is doing a progressive metal album?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Who's
that's
Victor
awesome.
Wooten?
Victor Wooten, the best bass player on the planet.
On the planet.
He's real good.
Currently.
Like we've lost Sabado to his music.
Yeah, he's having a moment, dude.
Did he sing on there?
It is a very meditative song. I think I could smoke a joint to it and just... Yeah. Yeah, here we go.
Like
here it comes back. It's coming back.
Music.
It's coming back.
Yep, still the same chords. Jesus Christ. Oh, poor public.
Oh, I think good. Who's somebody who listens to us and does whatever we tell them to do?
No one does anything
no.
that we tell
no,
them
No, one of the kids around here, doesn't anybody like us anymore?
No.
Not really.
We don't have any new... Like, maybe Randy. Not Randy.
What here. About him?
I'm thinking, like, maybe we could tell him to go back and listen to all of these and write down every... Dick joke we did about our dad.
Yeah, that'd
yeah,
be good.
And then we can
segment.
Make a book.
Yeah.
For his birthday.
For his birthday. And give it to him, yeah.
That's what I was going to say. He's all annoyed
illustrate
on there.
Illustrate it.
A good old scrapbook.
He's all, here we go again.
I think it makes him happy.
I hope so.
A piece of page. Yeah. We're auctioning off this here set, this here studio. Honest to goodness, if you ain't coming with 10 grand at least for the bare minimum of Chrissy's notes, then you can't get into the book.
Yeah, he's got a baby. You give him 10
G's. It's actually a scrapbook, and it's a fucking tangible piece. Anyway, we'll start the bidding at one sister for sale, one sister for sale, one crying and lying sister for sale.
Sister,
really not kidding.
Shell Silverstein.
Who will start the bidding? Can I hear a dollar?
Who's Shell Silverstein? That sounds
weather,
a little...
The weather, whatever the weather, whether we like it or not.
Who's Shell Silverstein?
Silverstein. A light in the attic, where the sidewalk ends.
A poet?
Oh, I remember that. It was
those big white books.
Kiddo book.
Yeah. It was a guy with a picture kiddo roof
book.
Head.
The greatest poetry books on the planet.
Were they poetries or
I don't
kids?
Care. I always
it's
find...
poetry.
I find poetry I used to do when I was fucking stoned and drunk.
Mm.
And it's dark. I'm a very sad boy.
I was trying to be dark because you're supposed to or whatever. You know.
Really this was cool. After the dark time.
This is like,
I was really like probably
you have to
early
be deep
20s.
And you have to use big words and
man,
fucking be
fucking
sad about things. And
in my soul, man.
Talk
it's
about
like
your
sand.
Endless detriment and all this stupid shit.
Yeah, it's pathetic.
Yeah.
Endless detriment.
Foe disheartened, monk attire.
That's why I like kids.
Shit and waked while queers conspired as they wept and pissed out prayers like God alone was ever theirs. Oh. Drinking piss with Mother Nature. I don't know. Jesus Christ in a malformed manger. Through his lies, a broken mist comes bitter sighs from broken dicks.
Is that a high school?
I can't remember what it was.
Is
no.
That you?
Yeah, I think it was close to that.
Look at
he was
him.
A
he's
poetry boy, remember?
For you.
But I screwed that. I don't,
hung out
I
with
didn't
them
write
poetry
that all. I, yeah, but they were all like... you know, Limerick. I used to go to all the slam poetry things, and they'd be like... They'd get real loud. It just sounded like they're mimicking, like Hitler speeches, only in English. That's what it sounded like. But I would go up there and they'd be like, oh yeah, and then no and sure. You talk to my child like that, and they get all angry and I'd go all this thing and stuff like that. And then I'd go up there and be like, hey, hey, this is I got a nice dick joke for you here. It's like sometimes I like to rub lime around my foreskin, dip it in salt, pretend like it's a margarita, and then I'd be jacking my dick and the cum would run down with the salt and get in my pubic hair. That was crazy. So I didn't know what to do. So I cut off my foreskin and then I would draw
lime
hammers
dick.
And sickles on the wall with my penis.
Hammers and sickles?
Poetry.
Oh, death. Oh, okay. Very nice.
Oh,
damn, we got real fucked up real quick. Were you
there
doing the dabberinos?
I think he got
he was doing something.
I'm auditioning.
He's on the heroin. You look like you're on heroin, you know, the haircut and stuff.
Well, he does look all hair, yeah.
Apparently, apparently I had wicked bad hair when I was younger because I really loved my hair, and that's why I kept it for so long. You know, Wolfman Jack and the leather jacket around Haunted Halloween moon time. You
what
know,
the hell is
I,
that?
I played the role, you know, my hair, it used to be immaculate.
Wolfman Jack.
Now that I sport none of it on the top of my head. Man, apparently I must have looked pretty bad back then because it was like, well, you look a lot better there, bald.
Well, yeah, because your hair looked like a fucking madman.
Love my hair. I'm the only one.
You know.
I'm the only...
It wasn't your hair was fine. It was the way you presented it.
Right.
Fucking looked like you looked like a serial killer at all times.
What the fuck do I look like now?
You look clean cut, even though.
Clean cut. Look how clean cut you look. You look like you have things together.
You could fucking get a job now.
Yeah.
Easy.
I don't know. He looks like a killer still.
Well,
slightly less.
Yeah, but all people who have shaved heads all kind of look like a killer.
Yeah, different it's kind like, of killer. More
he's
organized
still talking
killer,
about
though.
The top of my skeleton.
He looks...
I hate the top of your skeleton.
He doesn't look like a... He didn't look like a killer before. He just looked like a madman. He looked like a rapist. Now he looks like a killer.
Yeah. Wow. Now you look like a fucking... Look
I would
at,
love to be
with
a
the
raftist.
Army. You look like a paid hitman.
You ever go down one of them white waters?
I haven't.
No.
Never once.
There's a book
written
2000.
Mark Twain?
It's about Hillary Clinton.
Oh, white you water. Have television. You got to get out of the fucking
cosmopolitan. You better get out of the television business. That television business will get you, brother.
I know. You,
that's how you,
all your,
you ended up with them rabbits.
All your information is corporatized.
We should totally end the show with recording a song. You got a...
We're going to record a song together?
Let's record a song together.
Well, hey.
Well, we should do a... We got to do a patio music soon. A patio song, like a... And then, so for this.
Michael rowed the boat ashore.
We could do a Monday.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, we should do one.
Kumbaya.
My whole basement's cleared out.
Ashore.
We could set up whatever.
Yeah, let's go.
And I got all this equipo now.
Let's requit.
Equipo is Mexican for equipment.
Let's requit.
Equipo.
Requit. Let's requit.
I used to do this every single night when I go. We used to have a... Because you had to... Well, I had this poem I would do in my head when I would turn off the urinal.
Yes.
Oh.
It was like I have to take the pliers to the urinal to turn off the flowing
You'll
water.
Never know about that.
In the day, you have to let it flow, but at night, no one's there to... smell it. Something like that. So I did that in front of some poetry people one time. They're like, why don't you just fix a urinal? And I'm like, it's fine. This is how our urinal works. You need to use pliers to take it off, to turn it off. And then it occurred to me, maybe you shouldn't have to turn off a urinal with pliers every night.
We did that for our whole entire
yeah, like
young
in, until
lives.
Like 5 years ago. 10 years ago?
Yeah,
I don't
maybe
know.
10.
Maybe 10.
They had the urinal and they just had it run constantly full bore all day.
And then
our water bill, just that shows you how the greatest generation.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're just like, we'll just fix it with a wrench every day. Fuck it.
Yeah. Well, that's just how it was.
I think that's how they built it. Like, yeah. But it was.
Yep.
But they never thought to change it. Never, ever.
Not even once.
So the bill must have been, I bet you it went down hundreds of dollars a month just turning it off.
I wouldn't be terribly surprised. I mean, if you're going to do it that way, at least could you have like a rotating water or like a...
Yeah, something.
Yeah.
Well, and you know, it's old, so the different changes of pressure happen all the fucking time. So sometimes it'd be like a fucking full flow, like probably 30 gallons a second. And I remember the reason they changed it. Do you remember why? Some guy was in there and it splashed on him or something. He's like, your fucking urinal splashed on me while I'm taking a shit.
Well, he's taking his... So how did it got from... Well, I mean,
yeah,
I know
that's how high it flowed.
Flushed it before he sat down.
It was just... It wasn't flushing. That's what we're saying. It was just a constant waterfall.
There was... Yeah.
Fantastic.
Old school.
Just make sure you turn off the urinal.
That was our
leave.
That was our first shit job. As we were the urinal boys.
Yeah. You had to fucking wrench off the fucking urinal before you left.
Well, I still think it's a psychotic way that thing flushes.
Yeah,
it's
me
just
too.
Some weird star that you have to like fight. You turn the star,
turn
and
the
pee
star.
Pee goes down the hole.
That's right.
And
let's tear that out. You still listening, Dad? We're putting in a real urinal.
Yeah, dick's urinal is ruined everything.
That stays. That stays, my friends.
No, he likes it. I like trough style.
The trough style pissing is
yeah.
It reminds me of Old Mile High.
Old Mile High, the long trough.
Milo High Low.
Yeah.
That's when I first learned how to piss around other men.
Right.
Here or Mile High?
Without stage fright.
Yeah, you know, they had the old troughs.
He's got to relax.
I'd have just, to, yeah, my dad would take me to the games. I'd be standing on his penis.
Breathing the...
peeing into the...
What the shit, dude?
And that's
telling him where to
before
go.
Before we went to the games, my dad, every time, he would stand outside... on a scooter and throw his penis over his shoulder and 50 people would just hop on his penis and he'd drive us down to the ball game.
It's like the banana boat on the way to the Bronco game and on the street.
Oh, dearie me.
Yeah.
Oh, dearie.
They had little handles on it. People were just fucking
nice decals.
That's good shit. Lots of people in
the ball game.
I can pop his cock.
I don't even know how to describe the... The couple of years we had a double decker.
A double decker?
We had a double decker. He just. Just bend it in half for me, kid.
I'll sell this one piece as two.
He used to sell advertising on this on the side of it.
Oh, man.
One time we broke down on the side of the road.
Maybe this is the show we should have on, like, Pitch to Adult Swim or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Michael Dyer. Bus driver.
Double no, his cock. Dick. His dick.
Dick
double
driver.
Cock.
Well, I know, yeah.
Michael Dyer and his dick.
His hey, cock
we gotta
and
somehow
dick.
Sell two dicks here. All right, well, I guess we'll take mine. We'll fold it in half. And we'll be two dicks. The big. Like,
this is the recap. He just ruined that recap.
Two dicks.
That That's was so the good. Worst recap of the night. You did good
Michael
before.
Two dicks.
No, his Die. Dick's a bus.
Oh,
his dick's
apparently.
The bus.
Yeah, I heard. I heard.
Yeah, why would he say two dicks? I got two dicks now.
That,
no, you're out of the writing
used to take
room.
About 50 people to the ball game. Used to pull up. Used to jump on it.
Hey, we got to decide if we do sell that show. Are we going to bring him along?
Let's go.
Yeah, we always need him.
I mean, is he going to be a good writer?
Ooh. We'll get a yeah. That'll be fun
because he's sporadic, and most writers are sporadic.
Yeah, we'll
yeah,
get,
but he'll be dead in a year.
Yeah,
with that
well, that'll
money.
Be the best part of it too, because then we can like dedicate a show to him and tell everybody who watches this is the show for Paul.
This
is
there
the show
you go. That'll be our highest
your
downloaded show.
We would dedicate a whole show for you, Paul.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice. That's like downwind spiral. Business.
What did he say?
Downwind.
Yeah.
No. What about circles?
I've got circles in my
Coco. I saw Coco.
He's 60 years old. What do you expect?
I'm an elder man.
Todita. Yeah.
What
is about
he,
her?
Is he talking to me?
I think he's talking about Cody. I don't know how
Cogita
I know that.
Cogita cheese? Exactly. I love Cogita
I did know
cheese.
That. He was talking about Cody.
How do you know
Why
that?
The fuck did I know what he was talking about?
Well, I don't know. I don't
it, it was either her or that one gorilla that talks sign language.
I heard a couple very bad jokes. Can I tell you one of them?
No.
Let's hear it.
Let's do it.
Who's the opposite of Christopher Walken?
Jesus fucking
you
Christ.
You did that one on the show already.
Reeves.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
Tonight.
What is that there, that one purple triangle pill you take Viagra? What does Viagra and that there Disneyland have in common?
Yeah.
It's all 1 hour wait for a 2 minute ride.
Yeah.
2 minutes, you're a warrior.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
I'm just relaying the news. This is in line. I'm just updating the desk before we get out.
That was a new joke. The last one wasn't.
I just, you know what I do is I just go into a coma, and when she's done, I tell her to slap me.
Wake him up.
Yeah, then I know it's time to ejaculate.
Oh, man, yeah. It's
one time.
I guarantee
you. One time he was in a coma and woke up, smacked him. And she says, your dad's dick. Your dad's dick's here.
<Excuse you. laughs>
For the paper payment.
That's it.
He's my dad's dick used to deliver the paper.
Yeah, we had to feed him quarters.
Yeah.
Just put it right in the slot. Right in the slot.
Wow.
You want the post?
I think we've dedicated this whole show to Dad's dick.
Yeah, we didn't really have much.
We've done a lot of shows. The only time the show is any good is when.
Well, this is the whole show, though.
Yeah.
Papa's yeah, penis. Much was.
Yeah, the
Papa's
whole show
penis.
Is my dad's dick jokes. You know, my dad's dick taught Tiger Woods. Not Tiger Woods. Yeah. Tiger Woogs.
Tiger Woogs.
Not out of golf either. Taught him how to jump rope.
My dad's dick was a
jump rope champion. Is that what you're going to say?
Oh, yeah. It was a goddamn sport.
Fuck Forrest Gump. Dad's dick, way more shit. My dad's dick inaugurate. Oh, no, I broke something.
He broke everything.
He inaugurated Nixon.
Inaugurated.
Oh, I think that thing busted.
Oh, that thing's busted.
Oh,
now.
Goodness.
Oh, can they still hear us, or is it
yeah,
just
they can still hear us.
It's fine. They can hear us.
I could really
see. We don't need to be talking to each other anyways.
Yeah, we're
dead. Y'all boys be doing the voices.
The boysenberries.
Papa's penis.
Papa's penis.
Good,
you hear that, Daddy?
Cartoon show.
You hear his papa.
Yeah, just speak of it. Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
I got 19 guests in my house. What am I going to do? I'm going to divide the pieces of my dick evenly in all these bedrooms. Is it going to be a gauge win?
And I can all sleep on them.
Papa's
Man, that's
pee.
Pretty good. So you can come to the writing room.
I could see it.
He wakes
that's
up.
The only way out of us out
I got to shake the raccoons off.
I think they would do it. I think we should really try to do this. Why not?
So
we need to get
we got
some,
nothing better to do.
We got
to
get some of that dick money.
We should sell it.
Yeah, I'm in.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, right. At this point, Kevin Smith can make a movie about a walrus man.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Well, and then they made that Italian sausage movie, the supermarket movie where they're fucking.
Juno?
That's the only other movie he's seen is Juno and...
Juno and the sausage.
Juno at the end of sausage parties a Juno.
Oh, God.
Well, I guess we could play a patio tune and go home.
Let's play a patio tune and go home.
Yeah, that's what our patio song's going to be about is my pepper.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we need to make a good song about Pep.
Pastor of Sorrow.
Pep's Big Pecker. We should do a limerick.
We did Vampire, right, already?
Yeah. Vampire.
I like that one.
Vampire. Vampire.
Grandpa's always dead.
Not
what's
afraid. Grandpa's always dead. I think it's funny.
What is it?
Well, that's good. Keep going.
Might as well go for it.
I wouldn't.
He said, that's all right. Let's go ahead and. Did you hear him?
Hop, hop, hop.
Yeah.
Hop, hop, hop.
Yeah. What is it, Grandpa?
What else we got?
8 years ago. Jesus.
Oh, jeez. That one. Fuck, I forgot about this one.
Oh, this is a good one.
No, this is a terrible one.
When all the cards are in their boxes.
What the hell?
With all the Jeppermen. We'll attack the fortress.
Pissing in the wind.
Yoo-hoo. Mama taught me purple. Daddy taught me violet.
Is that a Botswana?
Yeah. Turquoise. Rebels always dead. Yoo-hoo. Cause I ain't got no hammer. Hated smashing things. I'd rather work the drill press. Inserting screws with strings. Yoo-hoo.
I don't think I've heard this one. We're trying to do an Imagine from John Lennon.
Daddy taught me all the things. And then we turned our tails. Daddy's always dead.
Grandpa's always dead.
That was a short one. Let's play another one.
Yeah, let's play another one.
All right.
That was a good one, though.
Grandpa's always dead.
Yeah, that was the one we did without you, I remember.
I wasn't there a lot
at that time.
We were trying to do Imagine from John Lennon, and that's what that was. And we had.
I've never heard that song. John Lennon? He's all happy. Look at him. John Lennon. What's Chris's? No, that's Chris's school song. Oh, that's one.
That's a dictionary song.
Yeah.
Right?
No, I don't know.
It's gotta be, huh?
Probably dictionary.
Let's listen.
I don't know, it says copywritten.
Yeah, it's probably copywritten.
There we go.
Now we have like it.
Yeah.
I think Botswana. Yeah, I don't know. Botswana wrote the lyrics though. I had to write a song for a school thing going.
Disney song mashup?
Oh, me and Lance did this one late one night.
I can't find the paper.
Is it any good?
About the breadcrumbs you dropped
away. Let me turn it up.
That wasn't a very smart idea.
You know what I want to investigate?
Why not? The birds ate up all the
crumbs. Why do all them kids always have breadcrumbs to be dropping around?
We are lost.
I'll pull my food back to my home. Come on, man. You're out in the wilderness. This is way back when.
Like
the breadcrumbs. Get boulders. Oh, that was breadcrumbs. Such a plethora. You know, you had so much breadcrumbs. It's like lint underneath the earlobe. Hey,
let's hear about the breadcrumbs.
Oh, sorry. I killed it. That was a good empty joke, though.
That's good.
I liked it with the...
I was ready to hear about the
breadcrumbs. That was like the... What's his name? The heroin comic, dead one.
The breadcrumbs. How come breadcrumbs was such a plethora?
That was like a Hedgeberg joke.
Burr.
Timmy and Tommy, they went on a trail and they came out with their breadcrumbs on the ground to go find themselves back home. Shit, man, it's been 20 minutes and all them breadcrumbs are gone. What was breadcrumbs like today's age? Like ants.
Yeah.
I got ants all over me. Oh, no. I love the word ants.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the part, good part right here.
I wish I got drunk like him.
We had a bunch of old Disney records and we kept mashing them together. We had like Dumbo, Hansel and Gretel.
And it wasn't one of Gretel's angels. It was the Wicked Witch of the Forest. She quietly.
Is that real record sound? I like it.
And as morning approached, the little Jew man spread his dewdrops all around him.
Jew men?
Yes, maybe you'd better sit close to me. Are you warm now? Are you warm now? Are you warm now? Are you warm now?
Yes.
Are you warm now?
Yes.
Are you warm now?
Yes.
Are you warm now?
Yes. 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 Listen, you fuckers.
Huh?
Listen, you fuckers.
Huh?
Listen, you fuckers.
Huh? There stands a little man in the wood alone.
That was it.
Oh, I thought there was another.
It should have been.
Yeah.
Me and Lance, after we had a gig at Bottoms Up Tavern or Glass Tours, and then me and him came to my house and we were going to do patio music, but he had all these old records, and it was like Dumbo. And Hansel and Gretel and like all kinds of old Disney records, and we're taking little parts of each part and we're trying to make it all nasty and shit. Yeah,
that's cool.
That was good.
I'm going home. You guys going home?
Yeah, no. We're going home.
I'm gonna do another hour with Sabado.
Tell us what's up.
We gotta go off air.
No, I'm gonna give him a whole hour.
And I like that. Actually,
we're gonna get down to the nitty gritty of.
We gotta figure out a way.
What makes Sabado?
Yo,
tick.
If I'm gonna make a fucking coin. You know,
no.
I got to get off air. But I do believe that we could create right about a moment or so.
No, we got to get. Next week should be nothing but him.
Oh, yeah.
Like, we shouldn't even be here.
That's a good idea. Yeah. We'll just set up. Well,
a soliloquy.
Somebody has to stay here so he doesn't break anything.
I'll look at him.
Or vomit.
No, I don't care if you vomit as long as it's not anything.
I had such. I could speak this because it's the truth. I had a glass and a half of milk.
Ugh.
Oh, I know. I was number one and out of my number two. And it felt like a number three because every time it had to come up again, I'm like, oh, no. Anyway, Jesus Christ.
Number three, huh? Is that puking?
No. Fuck, man.
Come?
If you don't know number Nummies? Three, you don't need to know it.
Yeah, I don't got number three. I got number one.
I don't think
two.
I've ever had number three either. What
number
is
three
this
would
number
be
three?
Ejaculate for me.
Number one plus number two equals what number?
Come. What else comes out of you besides vomit, I guess?
Oh, number three.
Yeah. Fucking tell
us
what.
One plus two equals three.
Mm.
Pissing plus shitting equals urinating out of your asshole. Plus two equals three.
That's three?
Exactly.
Mm.
Now you get it.
Thank you. You should teach a class.
What's
good night, everybody.
Good night.